Mercedes-Benz G500.
This is a Mercedes-Benz G500.
And quite simply, this is the most expensive Jeep ever built. But it is my expensive Jeep. And today, I'm going to review it. This has been my dream car for the past 10 years, if not more. I've been seeing this thing in movies, I've seen it on the street. Every time I see one driving past me, I would flip out and scare my passengers. But it finally happens, and I finally have one. This might not be the prettiest one, the newest one, with the lowest miles or with turbos, but it is still a G-Wagon, and this is a good start. To begin, let's discuss the exterior. This is a 2002 with a 2016 facelift. I believe they swap out the grille, the headlights, and the bumper, and the back as well. It's the taillights and the rear bumper. It does look pretty good. I would honestly prefer the pre-facelift just because why not? But there are a few things that I absolutely hate about this car. For example, fake carbon fiber wrap and humongous 22-inch wheels, which, you know me, I'm not a huge fan of big wheels. I prefer little wheels or wheels that are proportionate, I guess you could say. For this car, I'd prefer to have about 19 to 20-inch, possibly, with a little fatter tire. Not necessarily a full off-road rig, but something a little less ghetto, I guess you could say. And as far as the overall quality of the car, the outside is a good 5-footer. I guess the previous owners preferred to be flashy and do some really weird mods instead of taking care of the paint or doing a lot of maintenance on the car. But this has a M113 5-liter V8, non-turbo unfortunately, even though I prefer that for a little more power. This makes 300 horsepower. It is very slow. It is a big time gas guzzler. I just filled this up a couple days ago and I'm already almost on empty. So now I have to go to the gas station and drop around $100 to fill this thing up. But that's fine. I signed up for this. Silver is a pretty good color. I'm not against silver. I prefer white, silver, and black as far as colors for my cars. But in the future, I think I'm going to wrap this thing gloss black. Pretty much the same exact gloss black in my Mercedes because the quality of the wrap was a solid 10 out of 10. It was a pain in the ass to work with. And I am not a professional rapper at all. But with a little more patience and some extra hands, I think I can wrap this in a couple of weeks. Unfortunately, I don't have $3,000 or $4,000 to drop this to a professional shop to where they can do it for me, even though I would absolutely love to. But yeah, sometime after winter, this will be a different color, most likely black. I already spoiled it. But the wheels are Platinum Edition monoblock 22-inch that are forged. That's what it says on the wheel, at least. I have no idea what wheels these are. I might end up changing these in the future, but I'll keep it for now just to save some money because there's plenty of tread on the tires. The wheels are absolutely caked with brake dust, and they all need to be polished pretty good. I'm sure you guys have noticed the 5% limo tint. The front is a 20, I believe, and it's also a pain in the ass to drive at night. I could barely see anything. You may as well paint the whole windshield black.
I can't see fucking shit out of this thing.
I might change out the front, go a little bit lighter, but in the rear, I'm gonna keep 5%. I believe those are the big details I wanted to discuss. So now let's move on to small details.
So I'm sure you've noticed the mirrors. Those are also the facelifted mirrors, which do not work, which I'm gonna have to fix, and the fake carbon fiber wrap, which I am eager to peel off. Like, you know, I would understand if this was like a G550 or G63, G65, whatever, you know. But the fact that this is not, and it's just a normal V8 non-turbo, it grinds my gears when I see people up-badging their shit or putting on carbon fiber wrap in their cars. It's like, if you couldn't afford actual carbon fiber mirrors, just say so. Quit applying stupid vinyl. And there's a little up close of the front end. And of course, there are a few equipment issues. You can see the bumper sagging just a little bit on this side, and it's rubbing right there. I'm gonna have to fix that as well. Honestly, I could stand here for like a good hour and discuss every little thing that I'm gonna fix, remove, replace, and so on. Just because this car was repainted. Whoever prepped this car for repaint is an absolute idiot. I don't care what anybody says. I know you guys can't see the imperfections, but when you get up close, you can really see them. Like, if you can't properly paint and prep a car, just let someone who knows what they're doing do it. And now I gotta fix all this shit and actually rewrap the car. There's a little up-close shot of the wheels. The wheels aren't horrible. I know what they were going for. They were going for, like, the newer look, which I honestly prefer the older look. I'm totally okay with that. And if I had to keep these wheels, I'd prefer them to be an inch or two smaller. They look a little too big. They remind me of like carriage wheels. My first day of ownership, I had to spend $400 for a new key, just because the previous key was broken and it wouldn't unlock the car, but it would lock it. So that was fun. Also ordered a few more things like door actuators for the back because the doors would not open. Ordered some new blinker covers, whatever you want to call them, because those are faded and they're hazy. And I'm sure you guys are seeing how there's no exhaust right here. Well, the exhaust fell off. It's sitting in my garage, and I'm gonna have to weld it up and fix it. But there is one on the other side. Here's another example of crappy carbon fiber. And some door handles as well. That is also going to be replaced. And this trimmer here on the side, I'm going to remove and get some new one and properly put it on, just because this car was wrapped white before, and whoever removed the trim really bent it, and it's all crooked and peeling, which pisses me off, and I'm gonna have to fix that as well. And little stuff like this. Moving on to the back, the best part. There's a spare wheel cover. Again, we have some fake carbon fiber wrap that's coming off. Hopefully it is silver. And here we have some facelifted taillights. I believe they're facelifted, but they don't look too bad. I'm okay with them. And as we can see, there's the tailpipe on this side. Let's open up this heavy door. Very heavy, but I like it. I'm sure you guys see some wires over there. That's from subs. The previous owner had like subs and stuff in the back, which I don't like subs. They're a bit too much for me. I just prefer nice speakers. I don't feel like having my car shaken right all the way with the bass and stuff, so. And now the best part is where we shut the door. And you gotta slam the hell out of this thing. There we go. I remember a while ago when I used to work at a tire shop, a G-wagen came in for a tire repair. And I'm not even joking, I stood by the door for like solid 2 minutes, closing it and opening it, closing it and opening it, because I just loved how they sound. Like, I literally cannot get enough of this. It's like, money, 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 lots of money, more money. I'm joking, but it actually sounds really good. I love how heavy duty it is. But yeah, there's the new key right here. $400 for one key. But I guess it's not that bad. I paid like $700 for my BMW key. But moving on to the interior. It's starting to get kind of dark, so I'm gonna try to hurry up with this video, but there's the inside of the car. I love the steering wheel. Looks really nice. Definitely needs a good cleanup just because of all the gunk. The steering wheel did have a cover on it, which I took off, and then it revealed this beautiful wood. And it will have some very interesting seat covers, which I cannot wait to rip these things off and reveal the beautiful leather seats underneath. Hopefully they're in good condition. Hopefully. Let's cross our fingers. Cross our fingers. And you know, I mentioned before the fake carbon fiber wrap, which unfortunately there's some inside as well. Probably hard to see, but I'm peeling it off right now as we speak. So yeah, it's right here. Some on this side. I'm sure you guys can see right there. It does have a screen, which I'm not a big fan of these just because it makes the car look very, very, very cheap. But it's already in here, so I may as well just keep it. And I'm also gonna have to replace a bunch of the trim panels right here up top. There's one right there, one in the middle, and one on the side. The plastic is just broken, so that's gonna be replaced. A few buttons don't work, so I'm also gonna have to fix that. And then whatever the hell happened with this, I'm not exactly sure. So yeah, I'm beyond excited to remove these seat covers, and same thing in the back. Remove the carbon fiber wrap over here as well. And of course I didn't check whenever I bought the car just because I looked underneath the car and the car looked decent as far as the rust. But there's a good rust spot right here that I'm gonna have to repair. So that's gonna be a lot of fun. So guys, next time you buy a car, make sure you look underneath the covers, underneath the car and everywhere where you possibly can. Don't make the same mistake I did. And also, it would be nice if the actual owner was honest about the condition of the car and actually disclosed what's wrong with it. And I believe that, I'm not sure how common this is, but the pedal ripped off on the bottom. Let's see. It's a little dark. I know you guys probably can't see, but this right here is the bracket that completely rusted away that I had to replace. And I'll post some pictures up on the screen just to show you what I'm talking about. But pretty much it's an L-shaped bracket. It's like 105 degree like this. And the bracket completely rusted away just because the water gets right there. So I had to order some bracket from Amazon that's like this, and I had to bend it this way and just self-tap it in there for now just so the pedal stays in place. But sometime during the winter or after winter, I'm gonna go through and replace the floors, replace the bracket that I did over there, and then lift the whole car up and then fix all the rust underneath, which it isn't too bad. It's very minor, majority of it's surface rust. But you gotta think about it. This is a 22-year-old heavy-duty truck. So rust is to be expected, unfortunately. Let's take a look at the back, shall we? So yeah, once again, horrible, horrible seat covers. And if you take a look at this, rear seat cover, it is held in by one screw. Like, what in the hell? Some people honestly shouldn't touch cars at all. I keep saying this because now I gotta deal with this and I gotta fix it the proper way and spend more money. Because look at this thing, literally flapping. And for the door actuators, I'm gonna have to remove the door panels and replace them. I believe they're like around this area right there. And I'm gonna have to fix it on both sides. Pretty much the biggest issue with this car are the buttons that don't work. So I'm gonna have to go around and chase them and try to fix them. Another thing, the AC doesn't work, but the previous owner supplied me with an AC compressor and a panel right there that replaces this center console bit where you control the actual AC and stuff. And also the sunroof doesn't work. I'm not exactly sure why it wasn't fixed, but guess what? I'm gonna have to fix it now. Just like a million other things in this car. It does have 170,000 miles, which I guess is not super bad. I really don't care that it's a high mileage car as long as it was maintained, but I'm not exactly sure if it was or not. But the engine seems to sound pretty good and sound pretty healthy. I do believe it has a minor oil leak, which I'm gonna have to fix as well. So,
Well, let's take a look at the engine bay. It needs a pretty good detail as well. I hate seeing all the dust and dirt, so that's all going to be replaced. So yeah, there's the 5-liter V8 beast. So this pretty much concludes my review of my car. Thank you guys again for watching, for supporting all my videos. I genuinely appreciate it. My goal is to get to 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year, so let's see if I can make it happen. But as always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.